Hi guys, welcome to my channel, Infinite Advice. This is me reading for Gemini, you versus them, for the month of July 2023. And of course, there's a whole bunch of people out there. This is not going to be every single person's story. Take what's yours, leave the rest alone. Also, feel free to talk around the energy. I could always be talking to a cross watcher or someone that you're dealing with. We do have a new moon in Cancer coming up, a full moon in Capricorn, and which should be helping like clear out a lot of negative energies. That Capricorn full moon should be help clearing out a lot of negative energies. I had to put my dog away. She wants to play. But what's it called? And then we also have that Cancer new moon. And then we still have Saturn in retrograde. So that's like some people are receiving karma. Some people are receiving dharma. So let's see what's up for Gemini versus them for the month of July 2023. Well, not shuffle Gemini. Right now might be a time where you guys are both learning how to communicate, you know, heart-to-heart conversations. You guys are learning how to open up. And this could be something that you wanted, you know, to see 111 on my timer when I said that. New beginning. So someone could be coming in. This could be a past person or a brand new person where it's like it's teaching you how to be vulnerable. You know, it's teaching you how to get out of your head, how to communicate. Or even them. It's like they're learning how to open up to you, how to talk to you. See, trust and passion. So, I feel like right now you could just be intimate with this person, or it's like this person kind of opens your heart and you're having to trust them, trust the process, you know. Here in the center, I feel like you guys have this like strong magnetic attraction, but you see, there's a need to stay positive, to stay optimistic. On your person side, they could feel like this was a missed opportunity, but they do have feelings for you. You know, they could feel like, you know, maybe... there's not enough, you know, chemistry to keep the relationship going, but they do have a lot of romantic feelings for you. So it's like reigniting that spark even, you know, it is safe for you to love right there. And then heart-to-heart conversations at the bottom of the deck. I feel like you guys are very different, you know, you guys can have different journeys in life, different life paths. So else for Gemini, you versus them for the month of July 2023. Nice shuffle. You could be trusting this person, you know, and I feel like it's going to be a very positive move forward. Even if you guys are working on being partners, business partners, you know, just helping each other out, I feel like you see triumph and success. It's going to be successful. And I feel like both of you guys know this because both of you guys have a level head. Both of you guys have a clear mindset or are cutting out things in your lives. You see, here we also have truth and mental conflict. So I feel like you trust this person that they're telling you the truth, or it's like you know, the truth is you have to trust them, even though it's like being physical can make it complicated. So maybe you guys want to wait on that. But I feel like right now you guys are working on being honest. And I feel like here you guys are on the same page, and this is something worth celebrating for, you know, this union. You guys are pretty much are in harmony, on the same page, seeing things from eye to eye. And on their side, I feel like, you know, you're helping them not only love themselves more, but wanting to create this strong bond with you the more they get grounded. You know, I feel like they do have feelings for you, they just don't really act on it too much. So Gemini, you versus them for the month of July 2023. Two more shuffles. Six of Swords. There's a lot of things smoothing out for you. It could be emotionally. Some of you guys, you know, there's a lot of things you could be bottling up, especially with that mental conflict card. Yeah, that could be kind of making things complicated. So I feel like there's still some stuff that you're moving on from, especially with that star card. You could be dealing with an Aquarius and then that Four of Swords, which has a lot to do with introspection. So things may not be how they seem entirely with this moon card, but I feel like there's lots of feelings here with that Page of Cups and the moon card. I feel like you guys are just kind of like taking it day by day, like baby steps. But it's also like you guys are learning how to be vulnerable and come from the heart again. I feel like even though you tend to get stuck in your head about this person, you may not really show it with that Four of Swords. It's like, and then there's lots of roses there. So again, there's lots of romance here. I just feel like with that Four of Swords, you don't really act on it too much. You keep it like within. It has a lot to do with introspection there, and there's still healing that's happening. You could also be dealing with a Pisces, like I said. And on your person side, we have the King and Queen of Wands. So I feel like this person could be turning their back on someone. And it may not be you because it's not in the center. It's on their side. And then, like, these two people are facing, you know, they're back to back. They're not facing each other. So this person, I feel like you guys, even if it's like you guys are only dealing with each other, I feel like you guys may have a lot of pride, both of y'all, that is being smoothed out right now. The Devil card, you see, that has a lot to do with ego, toxicity, any addictions, any other messages for Gemini. You receive them for the month of July. And then with that Six of Swords, that's like the same as this positive movement card. So I feel like, again, there's a need to just have trust, be honest, and then there's healing that's gonna happen here. I just feel like, you know, there's still some, it's like you tend to get stuck in your head sometimes about things. Gemini versus them. You know, this person could feel kind of betrayed. See, on their side, they have 111. So they definitely have new beginnings here in their life. Whether this is a new person or past person, I feel like things are about to get balanced out with that Justice card. It's just, it's not there yet. You know, I feel like there's still some mental stuff going on your side. The Chariot, you could also be dealing with the Cancer that you guys are moving on from. You guys could be traveling, going on vacation, dealing with car issues, getting a new car. But I feel like this person could have cut someone out of their life. Or it's like, you know, they're balancing their masculine and feminine energy. But it's like they still feel kind of betrayed about certain stuff. But it's like they're keeping a level head. With that Tower card. Clarify the Tower for me. You also have another one. So that's four ones. Some of you guys could be dealing with like a twin flame. Or seeing a lot of 11-11 lately. With that Ace of Cups here and that Moon card. Again, I feel like there is a strong bond that is growing here. But it may not seem like it 100%. And that's where that need to be optimistic is. You know, trying not to sabotage this connection with that Tower card upside down. I feel like you guys can't really help it. Both of y'all tend to like self-sabotage the situation. See Knight of Wands here. You know, and this could be kind of an on and off connection. Or something that is just one day here, the next day gone, right? Or in and out. But there's just a need to have trust and get out of the head. You know, and this could be maybe you. You're the one that's kind of in and out, and that's where that mental conflict comes in, and you're having to work on your own issues with that Four of Swords here. Meanwhile, this person with the Lovers card, you know, could be a Gemini that you're dealing with. I feel like they do care about you. There's just some sort of sense of betrayal here. Like, either it's from their past or from you directly. Any last messages that Gemini needs to know for the month of July? You versus them. King of Swords. Knight of Cups. So I feel like this is slowly going to grow as you guys, with that Chariot card, move forward. See Chariot, Six of Wands, into success. And then with this Temperance card, there's just a need to be patient. Because I feel like, there's romance here, especially with that Knight of Cups. That's romance, that's feelings, that's charming. I just feel like this person is trying to communicate very honestly. You know, especially when, because I feel like they have a lot of masculine and feminine energy that they're balancing out, especially with this lover's card, you know. I just feel like there's betrayal here a little bit on their side. Maybe they've been hurt a lot in their life, and that's why they like to just keep it very honest with you. And then you can't help but still think about certain things. But with the Empress card here, there's a need to love unconditionally, whether it's yourself or love this person, you know, because they've been through a lot of things, whether it's with you or just in their life. Because I feel like they could have missed a lot of opportunities in their life where they have feelings, you know. They have a lot of feelings, but They're working on a lot of self-love and grounding themselves and balancing out their masculine and feminine energy, you know, despite all the betrayal that they've been through. Whether this was you or they just went through it individually in their life, you know, they've just been disappointed a lot. So I feel like right now you guys are just learning to stay positive and come from the heart, you know. Heart conversation, positive movement forward, and the Chariot. You guys could also travel, go on vacation, go for car rides together, cruising, stuff like that. But some of you guys may even be going in a boat ride to the lake. But I'm going to go ahead and close it out there. This is just predictions for the week. If this resonates, you guys are more than welcome to like, share, leave a comment, and subscribe. Much love. Please take care of yourselves, and I'll be talking to you guys later. Thank you. Namaste. Bye.